Today, we'll explore how water acts inside food and how this affects spoilage. There are many factors that affect a food's shelf life, how long the food will last before it spoils. One big factor is water activity. Scientists use this term to express the amount of water available for microbes, enzymes, and reactions inside food. Specifically, water activity describes the energy status, or escaping tendency, of the water in a sample. It indicates how tightly water is bound, structurally or chemically, in products. The notation A sub W is how we represent water activity in the lab. Combine the two words to form the scientific notation. Let's say you're going on a backpacking trip. Which foods should you leave behind because they need to stay cold? And which ones would be safe in a backpack? Drag each item you would take into the backpack. Strawberries need to be kept in the refrigerator to prevent premature spoilage. Burger patties need to be kept cold to prevent growth of harmful microbes. Here are these same foods lined up according to their water activity levels. Water activity ranges from 0.0, bone dry, to 1.0, pure water. Foods with low water activity last longer. Foods with high water activity spoil easily and must be kept cold to prevent the growth of microorganisms. Additionally, foods with water activity above 0.85 support the growth of pathogens, so they are considered potentially hazardous foods, PHFs, and should be refrigerated. Moist foods like fresh fruit or raw meat often have high water activity and spoil quickly, but some foods that seem moist, like jam or pepperoni, don't spoil as quickly. Why is this? How does water activity affect food spoilage? Let's look at this strawberry on a molecular level. Water molecules are a natural part of the strawberry's chemical structure. Drag the water molecule on top of the microbe and watch what happens. All living things, including microorganisms, need water to survive. Enzymes and chemical reactions also require water. If the water activity is less than 0.6, almost all microbes, including bacteria, molds, and yeasts, stop growing. Traditional methods of preserving food, such as drying corn or salting meat, work because they control the amount of water in the food, either by evaporating it away or binding it up. People have been preserving food this way since the Stone Age. Removing water by drying a food, whether in the sun or in an oven, is one way to decrease the level of water activity in food. Sun drying uses heat from the sun and the natural movement of air to dry food the traditional way. It doesn't work in every climate. Hot, dry, breezy days are best. A minimum temperature of 85 degrees Fahrenheit or higher is best. Foods must be dried slowly and carefully, protected from insects and pollution. With no water available, microbes can't thrive. Binding water with other substances is another way to decrease a food's water activity. One example is salt. Salt is made up of the elements sodium, Na, and chloride, Cl, one atom of sodium and one atom of chloride. Scientists write this as NaCl and call it sodium chloride. Each molecule of salt is made up of a sodium atom, positively charged, and a chlorine atom, negatively charged. Water is made up of the elements hydrogen, H, and oxygen, O, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Scientists write this as H2O. Water is a polar molecule, positive on one side and negative on the other. Salt is the same way. Due to the polar properties of salt and water, they bind together. One molecule of salt, NaCl, binding eight molecules of water, H2O. Let's see what happens when water gets close to a salt molecule. Salt's negatively charged chloride, Cl, binds water's positively charged hydrogen, H. One chlorine atom from salt, shown here in blue, can bind four water H2O molecules. Salt's positively charged sodium, Na, binds water's negatively charged oxygen, O. One sodium atom from salt, shown here as green, can bind four water H2O molecules. Therefore, one molecule of salt can bind eight molecules of water. Why would this help prevent food spoilage? Because so much of the water is bound up by the salt, microbes aren't able to use the water. Now that you've seen how salt can control microbial growth through water action, what do you think table sugar, sucrose, will do? Sucrose, or table sugar, is actually composed of two sugars, glucose and fructose. The combination of these two simple sugars, glucose and fructose, makes ordinary table sugar, or sucrose. The OH bonds in a sucrose, table sugar molecule, give oxygen a slightly negative charge and hydrogen a slightly positive charge. Therefore, sucrose is a polar molecule. Water is also a polar molecule. It attracts the negative and positive areas of the sucrose molecule. That is why sugar dissolves in water, and also why it helps to tie up the water molecules so they are not available for microorganisms to use to grow. Tap the simple structure to see how scientists render the formula and chemical structure of sugar. The structure looks fairly complex, but don't let the formula overwhelm you. It's really just chains of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Sugar has eight exposed OH groups that are available for hydrogen bonding. A sugar molecule can bind eight water molecules. The reason sugar is such a powerful weapon against food spoilage is that it has eight exposed OH groups, which can form hydrogen bonds with eight water molecules. Select a spot where water can attach. Returning to our simplified view of the sugar-water bond, the important thing to remember is that one molecule, sucrose, can bind eight molecules of water. Do you remember why this is so important to controlling microbial growth? Because the water is already attached to glucose, it is not available for the microbe. With no usable water, microbes can't grow and multiply. We know that water activity, along with other factors, determines how long a food will stay safe at room temperature. Now that you know ways to reduce water activity, you could prepare fresh strawberries in a way to make them safe in your backpack. What method would you use? Fresh strawberries start at water activity 0.95. See if you can lower the strawberries' water activity to make them last longer. Which method would work best? Refrigerate? Use a storage bag? Dry? Add sugar? Add salt? Refrigeration helps food last longer, but fresh strawberries still spoil fast. Packaging can help preserve food, but with fresh strawberries, packaging alone is not sufficient. Dry the strawberries. After drying for several hours, the optimum water activity of dried strawberries is less than 0.6. What if you were at home and you wanted the strawberries to last longer in the refrigerator? What techniques might you use? Add sugar to the strawberries to make refrigerator jam. Salt and sugar need to come in contact with water at the strawberries' molecular level. Cooking helps this process. To preserve jam, you'd need to follow several additional steps, but simply cooking fruit and sugar together makes jam that keeps for several weeks in the refrigerator. Now stir the strawberry concoction. A moist food like strawberry jam stays safe much longer than fresh strawberries. Moist foods in general have higher water activity than dry foods, but some moist foods, like jam or pepperoni, are less likely to support spoilage. This is because most of the water is tied up or bound by sugar or salt. Although jams contain around 50 to 60% water, they usually have water activity of around 0.75. The sugar and pectin in jams bind the water, making it unavailable for microbial growth. Look at this chart to see how water activity level affects enzyme activity, as well as the growth curve of fungi or mold, bacteria, and yeast. Enzyme activity decreases as water activity is lowered and stops when below 0.2. Mold is sometimes referred to as the opportunistic organism. When other microbes will not grow, mold takes advantage of the opportunity to grow. To extend the shelf life of foods, a water activity much lower than 0.6 is maintained to keep mold from growing. Water activity can keep yeast from growing and spoiling food, usually below 0.6. Yeast can be beneficial too. Water is needed for yeast fermentation of the rising bread dough. Bacteria. The anaerobic bacteria, Clostridium botulinum, will not grow if water activity is below 0.93. This level is very important for foods that are preserved in an environment that does not have oxygen. Other pathogenic bacteria will grow at lower levels of water activity. As well as water activity, other factors that influence whether an organism will grow in a product and the rate at which it will grow include temperature, pH, and redox potential, a measure of the tendency of something to acquire electrons. Foods with a water activity above 0.85 are considered potentially hazardous foods because pathogenic bacteria, particularly Staphylococcus aureus, can grow well at this level. Many fresh foods fall in the range of potentially hazardous foods, PHFs. As you can see, dry foods, or foods with sugar or salt added, have lower water activity than fresh foods. Many people are surprised to discover that moist jams, for example, have a fairly low water activity. That's why it's important to test using scientific equipment. Even though your guesses can guide you, you can't know for sure until you measure. Gathering accurate water activity values helps you label food products for storage and decide what kinds of packaging to use. Food scientists test foods using a tool called a water activity meter. First, as with any lab device, you need to calibrate the meter. Basic lab safety procedures. Before you start, there are basic safety procedures that need to be followed in all labs. Wash your hands before and after handling the materials. Wear gloves and safety glasses. Don't eat or drink in the lab. Be aware of dangling jewelry, loose clothing, or long hair that might get caught in equipment. Clean equipment after use to avoid the possibility of contaminating the next person who uses it. Always strictly follow the instructions given. Every time you turn on the water activity meter, test its accuracy by taking a reading on a solution with a known water activity level. In this example, we'll be calibrating to a 0.5 molar solution of potassium chloride. The package tells us it has a water activity of 0.984 plus or minus 0.003. To ensure the accuracy of your measurements, when calibrating, make sure your meter gives a measurement that falls within the range indicated on the packaging. This is indicated by the plus or minus symbol. Turn on the water activity meter and wait for the machine to warm up. The machine will alert you when it has readied itself for a specimen. Squeeze the standardized solution into the sample cup until it's filled about halfway. Put the sample cup in the drawer, close it, and start the machine. Inside the meter, water evaporates from the food sample and vapor accumulates on a little mirror. Measuring how much vapor forms on the mirror gives us vapor pressure, which the meter uses to calculate water activity. We record temperature as well because water activity is calculated at a specific temperature. Be aware that water availability in a food may vary at different temperatures. The machine may take around 10 minutes to finish its reading. The machine will indicate when it is done. Record the water activity and temperature shown on the screen. Follow the lab's protocol for recording all calibrations and water activity readings. Some labs require that all calibrations be recorded in a special notebook, often located in a lab bench drawer by the water activity meter. When we measured our standards water activity, it was 0.986. The packaging says the standard should read 0.984 plus or minus 0.003. Our measurement is within this range. Therefore, the instrument is accurate, and we can begin measuring samples. If the measurement of the standard is not within the range given on the packaging, the meter must be cleaned and the standard once again measured. If it is still not within the required range, the lab technician will adjust a calibration screw for accuracy. Measuring water activity has a huge impact on how we design food packaging. It helps scientists design safe and long-lasting food products. Understanding water activity also helps us know what must be kept cold and what we can put in the backpack.